is a useful thing we can do with the horizontal axis to make clear where we are in a time period. So just to explain it, for example, I'll take this, let's create a chart, perhaps that one there. So this first chart, the horizontal axis here, you can see, is just showing those. Now if I right clicked on it and I went to select data, over here it's showing you that the horizontal, the category axis, is coming, and those are the items that are in there. And I could edit it. So if you want to go and point somewhere else, you can do that. So let's see what you can do. Over here, what we've got is we've got some data. I'm going to highlight it. And maybe this time I'll use a slightly different chart. So let's go look for an area chart. So we'll do this one here. So you'll see you've got that data in. Now notice above here we've got quarter one, quarter two. I would ideally like this to show me dates, but I'd like it to show me January, February, March, and to somehow indicate that that's quarter. I'm going to right click, select data, and I'm going to click on edit, and at the moment Excel's decided that's the horizontal axis, but we're going to change it and actually highlight both of those. And when I say OK, notice that now what it's doing is it's showing me the dates, but it's cleverly put the word quarter one in the middle, centered it, and quarter two. Now it's important you set it up like this, because if I went and I put quarter one in all of them, you'll see then it assumes you just want to see the information underneath. So you can set it up like that, and that does look quite nice. What happens if we now want to have quarters and years? So let's go, I'm going to include it. This time I'm going to do a line chart. So let's do a line chart. So we've got our line chart. And what I'd like to do is have these split. So we right click, select data, edit the horizontal axes. And now I'm going to actually highlight three rows. When we say OK, let's go back and see what it looks like. So now you've got your dates, you've got your quarters, and you've got your years. So you can make the axes a bit more meaningful and a little bit easier to read where what is happening on a chart.